Afternoon, folks. Anyway, afternoon, folks. Just about to sort this chain of sprockets out on the rack for Q. Anyway, I've just loosened all the casing bolts, loosened the gear lever, pinch bolt off. Okay. Made this little gadget, cut an extension down lots of years ago. Don't know where I had the idea from. Probably millions of people have done it by now, but I've had it a good few years. Again, in your battery drill. Obviously, of course, I've picked the one with the flat battery again, of course, as I do every time. Fairly straightforward, this part is, to be honest with you. Chain's pretty well much destroyed. Right. Just open that clamp up a touch. Make sure the bolt's right way out, because obviously it fits into a little groove there. Might be a little bit of resistance there, of course, because it's obviously been on a long time. And there you go. Put your bolt back in. Because if you like me, you'll probably lose it. Obviously with this being on a ramp, that has been a little bit careful. Okay. Take it all the way off. These have got Allen key adjusters, like most of them have. There's all different types, all bikes, all different types. Take the nut off at this point, so it doesn't really matter. Right, okay. Let's see if we can. There we go. Final drive casing is off. Been pretty mucky. Right, at this stage. So it's good to have something to try to lose the bolts. All the little clutch push rod does up. Okay. So I'm just going to cable tie this to something, if I can find a cable tie long enough, that is. There you go. Cable tie to that for the time being, and hopefully. Still be able to see what I'm doing. I don't feel the cable tie on. Right, there you go. Hopefully you can see this. In the middle of this there's a little 10mm lock bolt. On a lot of bikes, to be honest with you. Nowadays they don't have any lock bolts, so again, just bear with me. Any any problem. Like I say, really, I should have found out all the sockets and everything. Make sure you don't lose any nuts and bolts off that. Little look round again. Right, so, a little bit of GT85. Okay. Now, folks, we're
using air impact wrench, always use, being too eager to get the job done. Done a whole load of work there for nothing. So, there you go. Lesson in life. Gonna find you. Okay. Right, folks, it's as easy as that. Okay. Obviously, you don't need anything expensive to get the chain off, but you do need something expensive to put the chain on, which is the main thing. Right, so there you go, the chain's off. It's got a lot of seized up links. There's about four or five links there that are totally seized up. So same again, entirely up to you. Right, so that's the sprocket off. Okay, put your stuff fairly safely. The sprocket's not that bad, I've seen worse, but the chain's totally broke anyway. Obviously, if this was my bike, I'd clean all the gunge and everything out, like, but as it's a rat anyway, I'm not going to bother. But it will kill me putting it back together dirty. So anyway, we know can't set the wheel out, which is again straightforward. But this is a rat at the end of the day. Obviously you notice this bike's on its side stand, which is which is great really, because unfortunately sports bikes don't have a side stand. Which, I've got to be honest, can be a bit of a pain in the ass. Normally you don't have to touch the back brake lever. Move it out. If any of your spacers do fall out, obviously, make sure you pay particular attention from where they come. And then, same again.
Hopefully, these are all the good ones, and we'll fit them Saturday.